Walt Disney's 1967 adaptation of Rudyard Kipling's classic, The Jungle Book, is one of the most well-known and beloved animated feature films of all time. So how did this film develop into the high-flying adventures of Baloo the Bear and Talespin? Let's find out today on Animation History. Following the success of Tim Burton's 1989 Batman, the early 1990s saw a resurgence in 1940s-themed entertainment, with popular films like Dick Tracy, The Phantom, The Rocketeer, and The Shadow. In 1992, Bruce Timm and Eric Radomski at Warner Brothers Animation utilized this 1940s aesthetic to produce one of the most popular and influential cartoons of all time, Batman the Animated Series. 2 years earlier, however, at Walt Disney Animation, due to the popularity of DuckTales and Chippendale Rescue Rangers, Jim McGann and Mark Zaslav were tasked with developing a new series based on a popular Disney character. With no ideas and the deadline for their series pitch meeting looming ever closer, inspiration finally arrived. After the re-release of The Jungle Book in theaters, Jim McGann thought they could capitalize on the popularity of Baloo, King Louie, and the rest of the Jungle Book characters for their new series. But the film was not the only source of inspiration, however. Popular television of the time, as well as manga, would help inspire the creative team moving forward. The short-lived live-action adventure series Tales of the Golden Monkey, by television legend Donald P. Belisario, was one piece of the puzzle. Released in 1982 by Universal Television, the series starred Stephen Collins as a bush pilot who flies cargo to a tropical island in the South Pacific. When he isn't searching for buried treasure or having other various adventures, our hero spends his time at a monkey-themed bar owned by his friend Louie. Sound familiar? To give their new series a sense of danger and excitement, writer-producers Megan and Zaslav referenced Hayao Miyazaki's 1989 manga, The Age of the Flying Boat, a beautifully illustrated 15-page watercolor manga centered around a pig-headed pilot who flies a seaplane and fights air pirates. The colorful adventure comedy would later be turned into Miyazaki's film Porco Rosso, released by Studio Ghibli in 1992. It was the number one film on the Japanese market that year. Interestingly, while Talespin's air pirates owe their existence to Miyazaki's work, their swashbuckling captain, Don Carnage, was inspired by 1950s Latin crooner and television star, Desi Arnaz, who many will recognize as Ricky Ricardo from the popular sitcom, I Love Lucy. Once again, pulling from popular television, Baloo's frustrated boss, Rebecca Cunningham, voiced by Sally Struthers, was based on the character Rebecca Howe from Cheers. The last piece of the puzzle, however, was a short-lived series produced by Saban Entertainment and Deke Animation City for NBC, named Kissifer. The 26-episode series ran from 1986 to 1988, and centered around Gus and his son, Kissifer, two circus bears who formed their own boat tour business after escaping to a swamp in Paddlecab County. Not only are the character designs of Baloo and Gus similar with their yellow shirts and caps, Ed Gilbert, who voiced Gus, and R.J. Williams, who voiced his son, Kissifer, would go on to voice Baloo and Kit Cloudkicker in Talespin. Combining The Jungle Book, Tales of the Gold Monkey, Miyazaki's Age of the Flying Boat, Cheers, and Kissifer, Talespin would go on to become one of the most interesting and well-developed series from Walt Disney Animation. Taking their young viewers on weekly flights of fancy, searching for treasure, escaping air pirates, and soaring across our television screens with lighthearted, high-flying adventure, The 65-episode series ran from September 7th, 1990, to August 8th, 1991, winning an Emmy Award for Outstanding Animated Program. Along with the typical line of action figures you would expect with the 90s-era cartoon series, Disney also released video games for the Nintendo and Game Boy, as well as a platformer for the Sega Genesis. An 11-issue comic book series was also published by Disney subsidiary WD Publications. Given my fondness for The Jungle Book, Talespin is my favorite Disney animated series, full of heart, humor, and adventure. I hope you've enjoyed this look back at animation history. This video was brought to you by Captain Matthew Nicholson. The Empire thanks you for your support. If you're new to the channel, join the Empire today by subscribing. This has been Vader Reviews, and always remember, you don't know the power of the dark side.